Here we go again with this shit. I do not want to keep doing videos like this, but because I wanted to be mocked and shamed out of existence, here we are. You know, on your Twitter app, if you click the search tab and it has this like for you section of the news, on that first screen, I see some nonsensical story about a black Batman. At this point, Twitter must be trolling me because they already knew, they had to have known that I was gonna say something about this. But what seemed to pop this off was a tweet by a guy by the name of Rodrigo Perez, who is a digital director and journalist. So with all of this talk about there being a new Batman in film, Rodrigo decides to throw in a suggestion. Now, who does he think should be the next Batman? The blackest motherfucker he can think of, Daniel Kaluuya. You may know Daniel from being Wakabi in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. And he did a hell of a job doing that. For starters, let me say that I do not doubt that there could be a solid movie that would be made with a black person or any other race depicting Batman. It doesn't take much to do that. You can still make a decent style movie of any genre with making that change. But what I'm saying is that it's an unnecessary change to tokenize these characters. Like Daniel has already played, there's a whole lot of other black heroes out there that need actors. It's a totally unnecessary change. And I'm repeating myself at this point. Characters like Batman have history. They are classic, they are established. And the important thing here is that Rodrigo is saying that he should be Bruce Wayne. Everybody knows Bruce Wayne is white as hell, and that's okay. But as more and more of these types sort of infest the comic book industry, they have a few like defaults, if you will, that they'll apply. First, they'll say that it's a fictional character. No sh**. That doesn't change the fact that comics are visual and they're not just mere novels. We're not blind, right? We've seen him and he's always been white. And again, there's nothing wrong with that. If they turn T'Challa into some white guy from South Africa, it'd be just as stupid and it'd be unnecessary. So we understand, you know, that these characters are fictional characters, but that does not excuse really tokenizing them. I'm not saying that you can't do it. I'm saying that it's stupid for you to do it. And it's a bit corny. The second thing they like to talk about is the suit. The character is just a symbol, right? You just throw anybody in there. Lazy. But even with Batman's, you know, his case, the vast majority of the time we know him as Bruce Wayne. Nearly all of the Robins at some point like wore the suit as just like this temporary thing. And even when the mantle was passed down to Terry McGinnis and the Batman Beyond, it was no secret who the OG Batman was. Many characters have had their suits worn temporarily by someone else, which we see them sort of get rolled into these like storylines. But aside from a very few exceptions, they never are embraced as much as the original and is generally seen as some sort of brief handoff or branch off. And this is generally more accepted when the character isn't tokenized and the person replacing him isn't a completely different person in physical features or some forced minority. Again, they are exceptions and those are just those exceptions. I cannot say enough. I don't care about timeline changes, different universes, is still whack. The excuse is that they're just getting with the times, and that has nothing to do with anything because the times don't ever require complete race changes. Usually people that advocate for this sort of nonsense are white leftists, social justice guys that aren't really into comics in the first place like that, and low self-esteem minorities that act as if they can only relate to someone that looks like them. So when they can successfully like achieve these race changes, they pat themselves on the back as if they've done good. But when writers lazily change the race of well-established characters, that's nothing to commend. When they give you Batman, Superman, and these uber popular white skinned characters, they are handing you the sloppy seconds. Instead of writing and expanding upon black superheroes, for example, they just change the pre-established ones so they can piggyback off of their likeness. So this means that the writers don't have to be creative or put in any work to gain that following around their character, and they can just present you with this token and say, look what I did. But what they actually did was confirm this idea that you can only relate to characters if they look like you, while also saying that you ain't even worth having your own original shit. Don't make Batman black.